Plus, Gucci, you too. That edit was hard, though. I made that edit. You dig what I'm saying? Shout out to the Penguin edits. The Penguin edits went crazy on TikTok during this season. But, man, it's Pat Brady. Super, super in the building, man. I'm here live and direct again with
Lil Lex.
You dig what I'm saying? We are live and direct again on Marvelous Blunts, man. And we are here. Last time was the Agatha finale. And this time, we are here for the Penguin season finale, last episode show, I would say. You did last couple episodes. I think probably the last thing I review on here was 4, so it can be like 5 to 8. You dig? So some things we're going to cover. But before we get into that, man, if you haven't already, subscribe to Marvelous Blunts ASAP Rocky. We almost had 300 subscribers. So, yeah, I appreciate all the love. You hear me? Like, y'all really showing love this year, man. I really appreciate it. Share this video, thumbs it up, man. Get right into it, man. But Lex, how you feeling, man? How you feeling after this finale, man? This finale. And follow us too on Pat Brady, 6L and NDs as well. Yeah.
Yes.
You did.
Wow. It was a lot. Like, this show has had me like on the edge of my seat pretty much.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
The entire show. Like, I'm like, oh my gosh, like, what's gonna happen? Is this gonna work out? Are they gonna kill him? Are they gonna kill her? Are they gonna kill them? Like, it was just all over like this and all the way to the end. And then the end, just like, what an ending.
Man.
what an ending. Completely changed the whole trajectory of what I had just watched for the most part.
No, for sure. For sure. You didn't expect any of that to happen at the end?
Nah. I love me a good twist, because I was sitting there like, they really about to do this. Oh, no. Oh, no.
No, I definitely agree. I definitely agree. As y'all see on the screen, this is, nobody thought from this little title right here probably that they was going to make this monster of a show. Mm-hmm. I definitely didn't. When I saw the actual preview for the trailer, when I think they first did the teaser, I was like, why are they making a Penguin show?
I think you probably sent it, or somebody sent it in the
group. Yeah, we was like, all right. Okay. Yeah, we was like, sure. Cool. But man, this show, Fallout was my show of the year. And this show was better than Fallout. It was way better than Fallout. This show was 1,000% how you masterclass a universe again. You know what I'm saying? Like the DCEU. Like,
see, they're two different. Those shows are two different things. Like how you said, like, that's what you're comparing it to, and I agree with you. But like Fallout was its own like thing. I mean, I know it's like a game.
Well, whatever, I'm still saying it's better. Like,
I'm just saying like your point that you just made, like in that regard, they're two different things, or two different types of shows, and just from what you said.
So it's just, I think Fallout had a better story. It had a good little story. It was a good video game adaptation, but this connected like how we be wanting the MCU to connect all the time.
Yeah.
They made, just Peacemaker did the same thing. You feel me? Like, they brought the Suicide Squad movie. Mm-hmm. Like, how the DCEU is putting all this together, I don't know how, but their shows are killing it.
They're cooking.
Killing it, dog. But yeah, we're going to get right into the Penguin. Man, this, I mean, from the last couple of episodes, y'all saw, I think episode 4, the last episode that we left off on, that's when Sophia basically made her stamp, killed off her whole family, the Giantes. She started a new family bloodline, you dig what I'm saying? And she's now officially doing her own thing after she finds out that Oz snakes her, you feel me? And when I say from episode 4 down...
Yeah, that's the shift.
Man, yeah. Oz became the devil on this joint. I'm trying to tell you, I never wanted Batman to beat somebody up so bad in my life. I never wanted him to beat a villain up so bad in my life. And I didn't think that was going to happen. It went from us being like, dang, I feel bad for the boy. And then
rooting for him.
And then you like, oh, this is what... And then, but towards the like last episode, I think, you like... Or the last two episodes. Because I think the last episode, spoiler alert, is the one with his mother when she got taken one. Yeah. The 7th and 8th episode, I was like, nah, bro, gotta go.
Yeah, I have never hated a character as much as I hate Oz. And I did not hate him until the 8th episode, the final episode. Like, I just, and I'm passionate about it. We We watched it days ago, and I still feel passionate about it.
Bruh.
I'm still like, nah, it's screw him.
Man.
And I hope he gets his butt beat.
He got to, because, like, I've never seen a show where they actually really, like, show a villain origin story, like, piece by piece. Like, layer it piece by piece. Normally, it's kind of just like, we just get the villain. That's it. You get the villain. This is who it is. This is what they're doing.
This is the motive.
But it's crazy, like, with him and the Riddler, they're, like, villains that, like, start off as regular people, and then their movement becomes just makes them a super villain. You know what I'm saying? Because I thought he was going to just be the spit on the sidewalk.
Nah, he got it.
He got it. This was all planned from the Batman. He's been planning this since the Batman.
He's that guy. I will say that.
Mm-hmm.
He a POS.
Mm-hmm.
A super POS. I've said some nasty things about this man, but...
Off camera, yes. We'll get to it around like 9 minutes. We're going to get to saying whatever we're going to say about bruh. Because bruh's a goofball.
Yeah.
But he's not a goofball.
No, he's very smart. But like...
Emmy.
Not... Like, I don't know. No,
he is.
He is.
He's an ooter. He's just an ooter. He just know how to oot.
But, like, you be getting caught, but then you already have a plan for when you get caught. So that's why I'm like, but you still be getting caught.
So, with him getting caught aspect, right? I think just him being, when he was a kid, him being disabled, he probably just really learned how to move in situations because he knows he's handicapped. You feel me? So he's always going to be have a disadvantage. And that's what his mother was saying. That's why, and that's what they were saying. He got better because he knew he had a disadvantage being handicapped. But this, from him even being a child, he was nuts. You feel me? He was literally, when Eminem said, Debbie had a demon spawn, you know what I'm saying? That he is like a demon spawn. I never said that about a character.
Yeah.
Thanos, nothing on him. Hella, nothing on him. Man, Hella wasn't like this.
Hela tried to kill Thor. She would have killed them.
Oz, in the last, he burnt somebody alive. He blew up his own. He let his own man get blown up. He killed his own partner. You feel what I'm saying? That's when the line was crossed, man.
Yeah.
That's when the line was crossed, man. But we shooting everywhere because we're just so excited. But what's some of the things that, you know, stuck out to you in this whole show, like that stuck out to you the whole series?
As far as what?
Just anything you like, dislike, you know what I'm saying? Things that were interesting that you just noticed?
It's been a while, I feel like, since a show has had me like that engaged.
Yeah.
Where like I'm not checking phone, checking time. I'm not looking the other way. I don't even want to go use the bathroom because I'm like, no, I'm stuck on this. I'm deep into this. Like, even the...
wow. But that's how grimy he lived. Go ahead.
Like, look at him.
Look at him.
Punch him in the face.
You just want to hit him with this one. No, you got to shoot him. You hear me?
You got to shoot him.
You got to get some of them YNs to put out a switch on him.
Yeah,
he needs a switch. He needs a switch.
Just don't work on him.
And it's so crazy. Go ahead. And then we go ahead.
And just to see, like, just character development and with him and Sophia. Like, I think both of their stories were freaking awesome. Sophia is like, she went from being like the villain to like, oh man, like, no, like, they did her dirty. We see why she is the way she is, and everything about her was valid.
Yeah,
she was not the bad. It's one of those, like, the villain but then the real villain.
Yes,
she was not the real villain. I'm not saying she was innocent, but she was not the real villain.
She was not the real villain.
Whereas I think in the first couple of episodes, and we talked about it, how I'm like, oh, see, and I think we always had this conversation about villains once it hits. We're like, oh, they're not a real villain. They have some good motive. And I think I brought that up. I'm like, oh, he wants to end up helping his community. He wants to be like Rex.
Yep.
Blah, blah, blah.
He wanted to be like Rex.
Yeah.
Rex was trying to smoke him whole time. Spoiler.
Be like the, you know, like the neighborhood ooter.
The neighborhood ooter?
Yeah, the neighborhood ooter.
No, I'm listening to you. I'm just like listening to you.
So like, you're like, oh no, like, he wants to be somebody that can like help the people in his community, but no, he's a sleazeball. He has snaked everyone, every single person he's come in contact with. He daggone near snaked his own mother.
Bruh.
Like, for real.
Bruh.
He got his mother in a situation and was gonna let them do whatever to his mother.
No, we're gonna show a picture. Y'all know it's burnt out right now. Yeah, but no, I was trying to show the picture of them. But no, he at this point, you have to realize what Oswald, I don't call him as a government name. He's a different type of guy. And I think that, you know, if you, I'm seeing like when they show like the people showing like the comics and stuff. So in the comics, he becomes the mayor. He actually is an Uter. You feel me? But I think actually seeing it like how it is, like how HBO's shooting it, you know what I'm saying? Even Colin Farrell was like, he didn't come believe that they were going to actually get us the green light to let it be seen and be shown on TV. You know what I'm saying? Like how the killing and all of this, the stuff that really was going on with it.
Yeah,
like it how grimy it was. How grimy it was. How dark it got. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It does. I think the comic don't get as dark as seeing it how they
this
did.
This is a very dark show. So if you're not into dark, probably not for you.
No, for sure. And one of the things overall I wrote was I said it was written and shot really well.
Mm-hmm.
Like everything had like different meanings to it. You know what I'm saying? And shout out to Screen Crush, not Ryan, but his partner. He was saying like how at the when that's on episode, I think 7 is when the sewers blew up. Yeah, 7, 8. It's six. Episode 6 is when they actually Oz basically went down in the sewer, started making drugs there, got bagged. Maroney came down there. Had a heart attack. You know what I'm saying? He had a heart attack. Oz, that was one move that got out the way right there. He had a mob boss. He was killing up all the mob bosses, basically. So Maroney dies, and Sophia sets off a bomb downstairs in his whole operation. And in that scene, he went down in the sewage drain. Uh-huh. Remember, he couldn't go down there when he was young. And they said in this scene, he actually fell down. He was pushed down there. Remember when they exploded, he kind of fell down.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Remember, he couldn't do it at first.
But then, because they were in that door thing. They like you opened the door thing and went down. Okay. And
remember this time when he had the ooh?
Yeah.
That man jumped down in the hole and had to ooh, you feel me? And I'm just interested just to see how much more can he get away with?
Yeah.
How long can he get away from the Batman?
Batman gonna get him. Batman always gets them.
You sound like a civilian, like a kid. Batman always gets him.
Think about it. Besides his bookie Joker, who he always lets get away, other people, Batman gets them.
He does get him. I admit, he does. He does.
But Batman might gotta catch a body this time.
You think so?
He needs to be a body. He needs to be neutralized.
He has to be a body. When I used to think that Joker was always his first kill, you know, like Joker always says, like Joker, you know, that's his boo. You hear me? So he wants him to be the first kill. It doesn't need to be Joker. We don't know anything about the new Joker, especially not that crap. If it's the Joker we just saw
behind the glass.
No, I'm talking about the Joker we just saw, the musical. What's it called? I hope he lived just so Batman can just beat the shit out of him and get him out the way.
He's not even
a real Joker. You hear me? But the Joker behind that glass in Arkham and the Batman.
Yeah. What was that about?
Charleston White says some people were just born to go to hell.
Shut up.
Why they had a picture of Oswald face half and half with King Von. They're comparing this man to King Von, cuz.
I mean,
that's how he was sliding though.
That's what I was about to say. Oz was catching some bodies.
And how do you feel about Penguin actually being in the supervillain category above some Marvel villains, top villains we thought? Like, how do you feel like it's him as a supervillain? Like, do you think he can be a supervillain on the trajectory he's taken from what he's done in these eight episodes? Like Batman's top villain, like a Joker villain?
Yes, because he's smart.
Smart, dumb nigga. I hate a smart, dumb, fat nigga too.
No, that's exactly what he is. Like, he's
who know how to move and know how to move.
And people talk to him like he's dumb. So I know other people know he's dumb, but he's a
finesser. But he's not dumb because
he's
like
a finesser. I think he's dumb, but he's a finesser.
So he plays dumb.
I don't think he's playing. Because
I don't think he's playing either.
We know something's wrong with him.
It is something wrong with him mentally. No, something mentally is off with him. For sure, especially how his relationship with his mom, that boy mom aspect thing, weird, and him killing his brother. That was dark, bro.
We're spoiling alert.
Spoiler alert. Oops. You know what I'm saying? But talk about before we get into characters with brothers. So we talk about characters, man. Who was your favorite character on this whole show?
Sophia, that's a bad bitty.
Sophia, what's her last name?
Giunti.
Giunti.
Because Giunti. We probably say Giunti because that's like how we
would
say
Giunti. 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 Whatever. Giunti Schmonti. Tomato, tomato. You liked her the most?
Yeah, because I really liked her story because she really was not the bad, like, by the end. Maybe, like, throughout the show. Like, I was like, oh, no, like, I really like Oz's character. But by the end, I did not like him as a person. But, like, her, like, even her going to jail at the end, like, honestly, I did want her to just get away and, like, start over. I did. She already had killed her whole family. I think that was a little extreme. That's one thing I did.
That was wild.
That was a bit
She cut off her bloodline.
That was a bit much. But I don't know what it feels like to be in her situation. So maybe it wasn't a bit much. Who knows? But I did. I wanted her to get away. So I'm happy that Oz didn't kill her. Like, I would have been blown about him killing her. I did not want to see her die at all. Out of all the characters, not her.
And she, and also, like you said as well, when she went to jail, also Oz couldn't kill her because in this episode, I think episode 8, episode 7, Oz is working with people in the council. With the government, like the people.
Oh, right.
So
right,
he's bust a deal with somebody who's on a council to push somebody else up. You feel me? One of the councilmen is going to push his position up, getting and bringing in Sophia. They basically put the whole thing on Sophia. Everything. Yeah. Everything. Season one of The Penguin is Sophia's fault. So
poor Stink.
That's interesting that, you know, they put all the blame on her, but Easter egg and spoiler alert, Selina Kyle is her half-sister, which is Catwoman, and she sent her a letter in Arkham, so I'm guessing they're going to team up to go kill the Penguin. You feel me? Because I found out, just doing my research on the Batman, the Catwoman was trying to kill her father too, Sophia's father, because he was the Hangman.
Unless she found out her father was
the Hangman. And that's the crazy part, how it all ties, that, you know what I'm saying, she's really not the Hangman, you know what I'm saying? And so... Yeah. She was locked up during the Batman for a crime her father was waltzing around about. You feel me? So Sophia was your favorite character.
Who about you?
Mine would definitely be Vic, man. Rest in peace, Vic, man. I think every character did good. I think every actor on this thing did good.
Yeah, I agree.
I think the best actor was Colin Farrell, the Penguin.
He played this role.
He's the best actor.
Yeah, he played this role.
But the best character, Vic, man, just to see... It's kind of messed up because it kind of shows that even people from your neighborhood, they don't want you to get any bigger than them or be at their level, because Vic was from the same neighborhood he was from, literally the same slum. You watch how Vic became. Vic was stuttering Stanley all through the show. To the by the end of the show, he was saying, man, y'all niggas some bitches. You know what I'm saying? Remember he was going, he was
letting freedom ring, y'all.
He went from when he remember that dude, the Caucasian man that he shot, mm-hmm. the first dude he shot, he was all like, by the end of the joint, when Sophia, when they pulled up on him, he was like, yeah, give me your gun. Yeah, give me that. Yeah, let me see that. He was too engulfed into this world, and it reminded me of kind of like The Wire a little bit, how Mac was with his character. Like, he was really like, Mac wasn't he was the quietest character on that show. Ended up being the most dangerous one. Mm-hmm. And that's how I feel like Vic became. You know what I'm saying? And he was getting money. And I'm really mad because he died for nothing. He could have went with that girl. He should have got on the bus and went. I think it was like episode, let's see what episode it was. We can look.
Wasn't it like his episode?
It was his episode. Episode 3, Bliss. Episode 3, Vic could have stepped off easily. Went to California, lived his life. He crashed a car. He literally put himself in danger so many times for this man, bro. And it didn't mean nothing. And once again, Screen Crush again, just seeing something they said. At the beginning, remember when he was about to, at the first episode, y'all, he was about to kill him, remember? When he was about to take his tires, he was like, please, please don't kill me. And then at the end, he did the same thing. He begged for his life at the end, at the beginning. His beginning relationship with Oz, he begged for his life. And at the end, he begged for his life.
That's so sad. Vic was a good dude. He was riding behind Oz, like.
But I guess it's one of them things where the show had to show us he's a villain.
Yeah, that was his villain moment.
They had to show us, I know y'all been rocking with, bruh. but it's over.
Man, I promise, if that did not happen, I would have been like, oh man, I feel like that's a villain. Yeah. No, I don't. He's a terrible person.
Like, he gets a middle finger because we passed 9 minutes.
And you know what's wild about it? Maybe it's like too real, like, because that's how, like, I feel like a real life villain would be, like, just like a big sleaze ball, like a big slimy, snaky sneeze ball.
That's what, like, I said. I agree. And not to cut you off, I agree with you saying when you're like, it's relatable. That's what I told. I was like, it's like it was relatable, like, and I think that's why people like it, because low key people like that violence. They like that somebody they can see depicted is just wilding. You know what I'm saying? And he came from nothing to be at the very top. But big spoiler alert: before we get into like some more theories and things, right when Oz at the end of episode 8, y'all, he's in the penthouse. His mom in the penthouse, even though she's a vegetable now. He got his main whore at the top of the top. They pan out. And finally, somebody flicked the light and said, Batman, where are you at?
After all of these terrorist attacks.
It's been blow-ups in the city. The Falcons are dead. Shootouts. Can we go down to, is it, how many?
A lot of people.
A whole drug trade was just made from a sewer.
All the Falcons died.
The Maronis is disappearing. Yeah. Burning to death.
A lot was happening. Where was he?
Where were you, Batman?
Everything cool now. Everything chilled out now.
Everything's chill. But look, Batman really moving like the government, like the FBI. He waited till he broke, got where exactly where he needed to be. And all of a sudden, he's gonna get that knock. He be like, what do you mean? Come on. Give me your best penguin and best pressure.
I'm not going to be able to do that. Okay?
Schmuck. He's a schmuck.
Ma.
He said, Ma. He said, hey, Ma. No, we got, so who else? Sophia? She be like, Oswald. They talk. It's like, it's not even an accent that makes sense. If y'all know in the comments below what accent is the Gotham accent, they would, he said, I mean, come on. What do you mean? It's the life. You know what I mean? Come on, man. What's my? You know what I'm saying? That's how penguins really talk. But
Vic didn't talk like that. Did he?
Vic talked like a proper young man. You feel me? Rest in peace, Vic, man. Favorite characters, man. And big shout out to Lauren LaFrance. I'm going to give her a shout out. She's the writer of the show. I think everybody keeps crediting Matt Reeves. Boy, you made the Batman, okay? You made that L.
That garbage.
You made that. You feel me? She made this, so shout out to her, man, because she wrote a magnificent script from beginning to end, connected all her pieces and connected it to the real universe, I guess, like the DCEU. So shout out to her, man. I wanted to give a shout out to her. Shout out to women writers, you did, and all writers, but her being a woman, because we talked about it earlier.
Yeah.
If this show would have flopped, her name would have been plastered all over this joint.
Yeah.
You feel me? So shout out to her, man. What do you think about the Batman 2? They're saying that the villain is going to be not Penguin, but Mr. Freeze. But what do you think is going to happen to Batman 2 based off this ending? Do you think that he's going to have anything to do with anything in Batman?
Is Mr. Freeze a mob boss?
No, I just think he's going to be a villain. Because I think that they said that they're trying to make the villains as human as possible. You hear me? Like, as relatable. So his character gonna be like a low level person again that got like a little bit of power that can just boost it up.
That's what I was about to say. Like, does he have superpowers?
No, he's a scientist. He makes all his stuff. So he, okay. but his whole objective, Mr. Freeze, is always trying to save his wife from like dying.
Right.
So that's why I'm like, I'm trying to curious, but look, man. But Oswald might have to run down on Batman and be like, I'm banning Vizanis. Because look, he's up there in the top of the top. And in the comments, they say he naturally becomes like the mayor. He's in the office. So if he gets on the board.
That would be insane. No, we're not letting that happen.
He's going to Trayvon Martin. He's going to take Trayvon White. Rest in peace, Trayvon Martin. But Trayvon White, he's going to Trayvon White. He's going to take that bag. You know what I'm saying? He's going to take that bag on camera. And Batman better beat his ass. Let me see something. Whatever. Tori, what's good? What's good? Okay. He said, I heard Court of the Owls is next. Hush is Will. So Court of the Owls, that's like, that was on actually on Gotham Knights. I can actually tell y'all something about that. The Court of Owls is like the rich of the rich, like of the under of Gotham. But they're like, they wear masks and stuff like that. It's like if them party, it's like a Diddy party. You know what I'm saying? But with owls, you feel me? No baby old. And it's like, but they be putting hits out. They be doing like little magic and stuff. They work with Ra's al Ghul and be having like owl soldiers. This is on the game. But I'm just saying just how they're a dangerous group in Gotham. Like if it reaches the Court of Owls, then it got serious. You feel what I'm saying? So if he's somewhere connected to the Court of Owls, it could get serious. That's all I'm going to say. It could get serious. So you were right about that, Torian.
I think it already is serious.
It's got serious in the hood in Ward 7 and 8. And the thing is, it's gentrified in Gotham. You got to think about it. And that's why that light went off. Because somebody said, a gentrified moved to Gotham, to the zoo. That's where the area was. That's what it was called, his hood, the zoo. They said, uh-uh. They saw bruh riding around in a purple. He went from a purple Maserati to a Rolls Royce.
Where'd he get that car from that quick?
Money, because I guess you know what they're probably doing. What we saw at the end of episode 8, y'all, spoiler alert, is probably a long time.
Oh, yeah, like, yeah, time is fast.
Time's
like,
fast.
Right. Because I'm like,
because where you get a blunt Rolls Royce that fast?
He was just reaching in old boy pockets.
Oh my goodness. Ooh, you're making me upset about that. Okay. I don't want to get too much into it because me and Les were sitting there watching it like this. Like, it was like a confusion at first. Cause I didn't know what he was doing.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. I thought
he was really just like hugging on him.
Like, this is my bro.
Yeah,
bro said.
He said, "I saw him trying."
I seen Vic do that uncomfortable stutter face he be making, and I was like, "Why is his face like that?" That. That's what Vic face look like every time something happening, and his face started making that face. I was like. He said, Oz. I said, why you keep saying Oswald? And he said, I can't let that happen again. I said, how is he even that strong?
I said, he killing him.
He not.
I said, you watching this? He killing him.
In the Jordans. I had a theory, but then people were saying he was dead. I thought he was going to be the guy, he was going to live and turn to a villain.
Yeah, what happened with that? It's a
character named Victor whatever his name is that cuts himself up on Batman. If you know, put it in the comments below right now, Torian. Anybody who's watching, Victor, what's his name? Who's a Batman villain? You feel me? Victor, I forget. He was in Birds of Prey too. I know, right?
Yeah, that's how I was like, dang, it's like right there.
Victor. But it's probably not him. You know what I'm saying? Because the name is just off. This is the part that's really messed up. Thank you, Torin. He's a John Doe.
Yeah.
And then they put on Twitter. You saw on Twitter what they put? They put a missing photo of missing thing. Victor Alvarez missing. If you've seen him, call his number.
So somebody's looking for him. Where is the girl?
Bruh, they put that on Twitter. That's why.
Oh, that's like somebody made that.
It's supposed to be like. After the show, the finale, the show tweeted that they made like a missing fly, but it's supposed to go along with the episode.
What if he's not
dead? But still, it's the point that the fact that Oz needs his ass whooped for real. He put knives in people's pockets. He didn't kill rats. Man. He didn't kill. Remember when they was doing the drug move? He killed his own men. He crossed both sides at the same time.
Yeah.
He's literally the definition of Always Sunny. When I say with Mac, when he said he's like. I always play both sides, so I always come out on top.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But that was a good episode, too, when he got caught, like, playing both sides. Because that was another edgier seat episode. I was like, oh, my God.
But it didn't even matter.
Like, how's he going to get out of this? He gets out of everything.
We talked about that. We said Selena didn't roll her sister a kite. You feel me? And said, hey, man. I know this dude, and he might help us get Penguin back. You feel me? But whole time is Batman. You feel what I'm saying? I just want to see what Sophia going to do. I just hope all of them jump Oz.
Yeah. Hope every guy can get their licking.
Oz can get in the corner. He be like, uh-oh, I think they finna.
Is that a boot?
He says, that a boot? He said, they stomping the shit out of me. She said, is that a boot? He just going to see, Sophia's red bottom. Boom, boom.
Oh, yeah. And all her outfits was hitting. Yeah. They like really styled her well to like, it fit her, like her personality. I don't know.
Batman going to have to flip that car again. Because, but this time he going to actually have to drag him out and beat him.
He just hasn't been beat enough, Torian.
Some people have need to get beat a little bit more just to know they need to get beat enough. But he definitely has a cell waiting. Oz, you have a cell waiting for you in Arkham, okay? It is a cell waiting for your fat ass in Arkham.
I'd rather him be in jail than Sophia.
Free her.
I really don't. I mean, she do deserve it, but between the two.
He did have all that. He had the hot top hat. He had the umbrella. They about to make him and Oswald Cobblepot. You know what I'm saying? Oswald Cobblepot. So what would you give the season overall? What would you give the grade for the season overall? A 9?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. We had the lighter? No. Oh, yeah. You do it. Lighter's up. 9. We got a 9.
It was really good. I really enjoyed it. I was sad that it was over. I was like, dang, it's really the last episode. So
I definitely agree. That's what I was like the whole time of episode 8. Cause I was kind of like, damn, dog. Like, how is it going? He said it had no damn. No, I agree. It had none.
Yeah.
He said, give them all awards.
Yeah. Everybody.
I think that them. Them and Fallout is going to have a good award run. I'm glad that two shows that I like are going to probably be nominated for endless awards, dog. Yes, give them all the awards. I definitely give it a super lighters up. I gave it a 10. I just think, like you said, it was from beginning to end, it was just great. I watched it. Got to episode 4, like I said, and just stopped reviewing it. I just started watching it. That's how good it got. For people who hated the Batman, like literally did not like the Batman,
like me.
For this to be a part of that universe is a beautiful thing. It looks like they know what they're going to be doing in DCEU. Now, James Gunn, you start with a banger. You basically started with a banger. This is him. This has to do with him, with his executive. Like what he's watching. So I'm really excited, James. I'm see you, Peacemaker. They just did a teaser for Peacemaker too. I forgot to tell you. It's a teaser out for Peacemaker.
Now that's a good show, guys. If you haven't watched it yet, go watch it.
A great show. Peacemaker season 2. I can't wait for that.
It's a funny show. It's not like dark like this one.
And it still ties into the DCEU.
Yeah.
You hear me? So Marvel, no offense, please take your notes. Take your notes on how to do this,
for
man.
Shows.
Cause 10 out of 10 for me. And James Gunn gotta prove himself with Superman next year. See, I don't give a fuck about Superman. You know what I'm saying? So I'll let the streets decide that. You know what I'm saying? The streets.
Y'all gonna go watch it?
I'm not. I like Superman, but I don't. You feel me?
Not enough to go to the movies to see it.
I might see it when it come on here. You know what I'm saying? It depends on how I feel. And you know, I'm not going to speak too soon. I'm going to wait till the trailer comes out.
True, because the trailer
comes. James Gunn said it is ready. He said it's already ready. So he's probably was waiting to see how this went. And it was like, all right, bet. Now let's push DC stuff. But one thing we don't want y'all to keep pushing is no stupid DC stuff.
All right.
Like Suicide Squad.
2.
Like Shazam.
2.
Black Adam was cool. But still, when I go back to it, I'm like, we didn't even rewatch it. You feel me?
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Joker 2. Dang, all the 2s was just trash. Maybe 2s is not a DC thing. Joker 2. Oh my god, I don't even want to get into that, man. But do you have anything else about the review, man? We just gave our review of the Penguin. You know what I'm saying? Any other things that you think about, anything like that?
No, I'm good. I think it is a good show, man.
Yeah, no, we definitely covered it, man. Shout out to Lex pulling up, man, for the Penguin review, man. This was the last episode review, man. We went every episode crazy, man. Shout out to the Penguin. Shout out to DC. Anybody who hasn't watched this show, go watch it. And if you did watch it, let us know in the comments below if you loved it. Give your spiel before you go, man.
Everybody follow Marvelous Blunts. And you can follow me on Instagram, SIXELAENBYS.
You did. Follow her. Let's crawl. Let's come on Thursday. Amazon. You put that in the group chat, and I don't know what that is. But I was Cross, which comes out on Thursday. I don't have Amazon Prime.
Why you looking at me?
Look, because you do. That's what I'm saying. That's how I'm like.
We got to find a trailer.
I got to look into it. Or send a trailer to the group chat. How about that? Send a trailer to the group chat, and we'll definitely look into it. Because I haven't been on Amazon Prime in a minute since Fallout. I'll say since Fallout. Mm. But if you haven't already, man, subscribe to Marvelous Blunts ASAP Rocky, man. We appreciate all the love, man. I appreciate all the love, man. This is the end of the Penguin. Tomorrow, I'm going to be streaming, playing BJ. And we're not going to be playing each other. We're going to actually be playing Call of Duty together. So that's going to be up here, too. So if you haven't, yeah, tune in, man. And we gone. Yeah.